for the Hollister School District. They met this afternoon to finalize layoffs, but did manage to save more than a dozen jobs. More on what the latest round of cuts means, though, from Action News reporter Brittany Nielsen. She's live in Hollister. Brittany?
Well, Dan, it means that Hollister School District libraries and computer labs stay open and maintain current service levels at least for the coming year. The school board kept those services and employees and still cut about $750,000.
I have two breaks and two lunches after long.
Cindy Brown has been a library tech in Hollister schools for 22 years. When she walked into Tuesday's school board meeting, she didn't know if she'd come out with her job.
It's been a long summer not knowing. I can only speak for myself, but it's been really unsettling.
We're still looking at these placeholders, but now these placeholders are real people.
Fortunately for Cindy, she and the other seven library techs left with their jobs. So did the district's computer lab supervisors, but only after heated debate.
And if we do not give them computers or libraries, we are not giving them the tools to succeed.
I hate to say it this way. I don't want to sound ruthless. I don't want to sound uncaring. But computers and librarians do not directly affect what's being taught in the classroom.
Oh, I disagree.
The teachers, excuse me.
For $90,000 to be able to keep a computer lab at each school staffed at the level that it is right now is something that I'm willing to support. And I feel as strongly as Mr. Hatchett does the opposite.
Others worry other options haven't been fully explored.
It just worries me that we've gone over this over and over again, and I still have yet to see cuts made away from employees.
In all, more than 20 employees were laid off, most not full-time, including custodians and instructional aides. 14 library tech and computer supervisor jobs were saved.
I wasn't willing to live with that.
I move that we approve 0510-11.
I don't hear a second. Motion died for lack of a second.
Brown is thankful she won't have to.
It'll feel really good for myself, obviously. It'll be a relief. But for the people that lost their jobs that I've worked with for years, it's going to be really hard to say goodbye and know that they're going to be struggling.
Now, keeping computer lab and library positions today costs the district somewhere around $170,000. But what board members are hoping is that that balances out with a vacant principal position that they are not planning on filling, which is worth about $125,000. Also worth noting, guys, is that the district has cut somewhere in the neighborhood of $4 million in the last 4 to 5 months already. Dan, Aaron.
All right. Thank you, Brittany. The Hollister School District doesn't have a deficit right now, but does expect to be have a deficit of more than $1 million in the following 2 years. But they have to wait and see just how the state budget will be impacting their schools.